نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم ما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Your Excellency Dr. Osama Al-Azhari Minister of Waqaf the Arab Republic of Egypt Dr. Nazir Ayad Mufti of Egypt Excellencies the ministers ambassadors distinguished guests Scholars, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum. I stand before you today as Pakistan's Federal Minister for Religious Affairs and Interfaith Harmony. I am honored to address this esteemed gathering at 35th General International Conference of the Supreme Council of Islamic Affairs, uniting us on a topic that resonates profoundly with our collective pursuit for a more equitable and enlightened world, the role of women in building awareness. As we gather at this international conference, our exploration of this theme will probe into four critical areas where women have been the and continue to be pivotal: religious awareness, cultural awareness, community services, and the nurturing of family and child development. Each of these domains highlights not only the invaluable contributions of women, but also the potential for further growth and impact. The role of women in building awareness, particularly in spreading knowledge, promoting change, and upholding justice, is well recognized in Islam. The Holy Quran describes Whoever does righteous, whether male or female, while being a believer, we will surely cause him to live a good life and we will surely give them their reward according to the best of what they used to do. This verse emphasizes that both men and women are equally responsible for doing good and building a just society. Their efforts are recognized and rewarded by Allah. Similarly, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, How excellent are the women of the Ansar. Modesty did not prevent them from becoming learned and faith. This hadith highlights the importance of women seeking knowledge and understanding of the religion, a crucial aspect of building awareness in society. By empowering women to take on leadership role in religious communities, We not only honor their contribution, but also enhance the inclusivity and depth of religious discourse. Esteemed guests, services encompassing healthcare, education, social work, and advocacy are essential for the well-being and development of communities. Women's involvement in these areas has been transformative and continues to be vital. In healthcare, Women have been pioneers in both practice and policy. Women continue to lead efforts in global health initiatives, mental health advocacy, and disease prevention. Their dedication to caring for individuals and communities emphasizes the critical role of women enhancing public health. The Quran signifies and elaborates the role of women principally as the believing men and believing women are allies of one another. They enjoin what is right and forbid what is wrong. This verse signifies that both men and women share the responsibility of promoting good and preventing wrong in their communities, underscoring the active role of women in society. This verse emphasizes the equality of men and women in terms of their spiritual duties and rewards they receive. It reinforces that both men and women are equally capable and responsible for contributing to the betterment of society through righteous actions. Women therefore play a crucial role in raising awareness and promoting good within their communities. Ladies and gentlemen, from grassroots organizations to international NGOs, women are leading efforts to provide quality education, combat poverty, and empower communities. By supporting women, we strengthen the fabric of our societies. The family unit is the bedrock of society, and women's roles within it is fundamental to its nurturing and development. From childbirth to education, women's contributions to family life and a child's upbringing are profound and multifaceted. Historically, women have been the primary caregivers, imparting values, traditions, and education to children. Their role extends beyond mere caregiving to include shaping the emotional and intellectual growth of the next generation. This influence is reflected in the emphasis on mental health, early childhood education, and supportive parenting practices. In contemporary contexts, women's role in family life are evolving. They are balancing professional careers with family responsibilities. Their involvement in shaping family policies and child developing programs ensure that the needs of children are met and that the family life is supported in a balanced and inclusive manner. Ladies and gentlemen, in last, I would say that the role of women in building awareness across religious, cultural, societal, and familial domains is profound and transformative. We must recognize and celebrate their achievements, ensuring that their voices and efforts are valued and supported. Together, let us champion the invaluable role of women in shaping the future for the betterment of all. It is essential here to recognize the profound contributions of Egypt, particularly Al-Azhar University, in nurturing Islamic scholarship and fostering a deep understanding of the faith. For centuries, Al-Azhar has been a beacon of knowledge, guiding generations with its rich legacy of wisdom and learning. The university continues to play a pivotal role in shaping the minds and hearts of Muslims worldwide, ensuring that the values of Islam are preserved and propagated with clarity and compassion. May Egypt and Al-Azhar continue to shine as pillars of knowledge and guidance for the Ummah. In closing, I extend my deepest gratitude to the Honorable President, Excellency Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, in hosting this remarkable international conference on the role of women in building awareness. Your leadership in championing this vital cause will undoubtedly inspire positive change across the globe. I also appreciate Excellency Dr. Osama Al-Azhari's efforts for this event, who is an eminent scholar and whose services as the Minister of Awqaf are remarkable. His role is exemplary in overseeing the administration and management of religious endowments in Egypt. Thank you for your vision and commitment. Wa akhiru da'wana, wa akhiru da'wahum alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.